Ako po si Ronald Alejo Geriba. Kilala rin po ako sa pangalang Lambert. 32 years old. Dito po ako lumaki sa Manila. I was a former student athlete during my younger days. This past 30th Southeast Asian Games that we hosted here in the Philippines, I was assigned as competition manager for aquatic swimming. So basically, we run, me together with my workforce under our National Sports Association, Philippine Swimming Incorporated, ran the full competition of aquatic swimming in the 30th SEA Games. But it started me being a former athlete and then eventually representing the country also in the Southeast Asian Games. I've been part of the SEA Games for 5 editions. 3 for swimming, 2003, 2005, and 2007. Then for water polo, 2009 and 2011. I've been involved with the swimming community as coach, being coach of PUP. I also handled before Miriam College, the National University. I handled NU for 2 seasons in the UAAP and Arellano University, and of course this club, Manila Streamliners. For the SEA Games, normally a year to 6 months before is basically preparation of the documents needed, requesting of equipments and all those things. So basically yun yung task at hand during pre-competition period. What we actually did is more of like meetings. How we're going to run the competition itself, the preparation of the venue, the preparation of the games time proper. I mean, yung technicalities like yung mga order of events, the sessions, how many days are we going to run the meet, its timeline, the wayfindings inside the facility, because as you know, the facility that we utilized during the 30th SEA Games was actually a brand new facility. It's in New Clark City in Capas, Tarlac. Ang pinakamalaking trabaho is all of the paperwork, lalo na yung preparation leading. Siguro malaking bagay din kung bakit, although yung problema naman hindi nawawala yan, especially sa events. It's a matter of how we do our work around and how we troubleshoot the problems that arises during games time. Pinakamahirap siguro yung naalala ko lang kasi bigla, no? It was actually days before games time for aquatic swimming when a typhoon came, si Tisoy, no? So, yun, medyo malaking challenge sa amin. In fact, in preparation for the arrival of Tisoy, kasi at first, yung kanyang trajectory path is towards north. So basically, tatamaan talaga yung area namin, which is yung Tarlac. Bigla lumis si Tisoy papunta ng south. So, yeah, yun. Yun yung mga problems na medyo mahirap on our end as events organizer or manager. Nature yan eh. Hindi mo mapipigilan yung mga ganong instances. So it's either we delay, we postpone, or we cancel. So lahat yun mabigat on our end, no? As organizers for us to come up with a decision. But yeah, tumakbo naman yung laban, hindi kami tinamaan ni Tisoy, lumiis siya. Pamilya ko, yung dalawa kong anak, tsaka yung misis ko, si Ruan. Actually, lahat ng ginagawa ko, especially yung mga nagiging success natin pagdating sa trabaho, malaking parte sila noon, ano? Especially itong SEA Games na to, isa sa pinakamalaking challenges that I encountered. All of my other commitments as a professor in PUP, in main campus, and handling different teams, bigla akong na-assign doon sa competition manager for the SEA Games. So, lahat yon apektado of course yung family ko, no? Bawas yung oras ko sa pamilya, minsan naalis ako ng umaga, uuwi ako gabi, pag-uwi ko, pagkatas kumain, minsan medyo limitado pa rin yung oras sa kanila kasi kailangan kong gawin yung mga dokumento na ipepresent ako kinabukasan or the other day or yung mga requirements na hinihingi sa amin. Matutulog ako, pagtulog ko, tulog na, bago pa lang ako matulog, habang ginagawa ko yung trabaho, tulog na sila eh. Matulog. Eh, kinabukasan, kailangan ko ulit gumising na maaga. The difficulty that I experience, not just physically, yung katawan, medyo bata pa rin naman tayo, no? I can consider myself na hindi pa naman tayo ganun katanda. I'm only 32. Yun nga lang, mentally, medyo stressed. Kasi there are a lot of things that are definitely out of your control. You have to do something about it, di ba? Hindi ka naman pwedeng magmukmok dyan na wala namang magbabago. So basically, you have to do something to troubleshoot yung problema na nag-arise. As a former athlete in the field, no? Of course, it takes some managerial skills and of course, yung decision-making, especially yung mga crucial moments na may kailangan kang desisyonan. The success of collective efforts, not only by me as the competition manager, of course, I have my other managers too under me, the services, technical operations manager. I also have coordinators and associates under me na if without them, the event itself will not be successful. It was the first Olympic qualifying event for swimming that we held here in Philippine soil. We actually applied it through the international governing body for aquatics, FINA, and they approved the SEA Games as Olympic qualifying event. So the results of that SEA Games from last year was actually being recognized by the international governing body. So whoever got the qualifying times during that event will actually be swimming in the Tokyo Olympics next year. Alam nyo yung success on the field that you chose aside from your academics is actually based on you as a person. Nasa sa atin yun kung paano natin i-hone yung skills natin. The commitment. You have to set that. Na gusto nating ituloy and pagbutihin pa. So later on, we can pass on to my children. Sana ganun din sila, no? Kasi ito yung naiwan sa amin. Ito yung naiwan actually ng father ko. Eh. Siguro, masasabi ko rin, parang pamana. No? Walang material eh. Walang material. Pero mas malaki pa dun sa material na bagay na ipamana niya sa akin. Ito kung ano rin ako siguro ngayon. Sito rin siya before.